Dominican Friars in Rwanda. Meditation of Friday of the 24th week in ordinary time. If Christ has not raised, then empty is our faith. Brothers and sisters, today, in his letter to the Corinthians, St. Paul takes us back to the central mystery of our Christian faith, the resurrection of Jesus Christ, which leads to our own resurrection. Resurrecting from the dead, a joke for the Sadducees who don't believe in the afterlife, and a folly for the people of Athens in the days of Paul's preaching. As for the resurrection of Jesus Christ, an absurdity for atheist scientists for whom this story is not sealed with any logical proof capable of proving its authenticity. You know, brothers and sisters, any objective historian admits that the existence and crucifixion of a certain Jesus of Nazareth is an historical fact. And several ancient testimonies, Christian or not, have repeatedly endorsed it. Even Jesus' fiercest opponents, such as the religious leaders of the Jews, never denied the existence, crucifixion, and the death of Jesus. Nevertheless, his death was followed by an incredible episode for unbelievers, the resurrection. In fact, how is this possible? How can a man who was arrested, tortured, humiliated, and killed without any power of self-defense can now do what is extremely beyond any ordinary human power, to raise from the dead? What folly to believe in such an event. How illogical to admit such an assertion. But let us appreciate, brothers and sisters, that it is exactly this holy folly that animates us since Easter time. It is this sacred illogicality that is at the heart of the mystery of our faith. Because Christ is truly risen from the dead to be the first to be raised among the dead, says St. Paul in his letter today. And through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, we died to the vanity of our worldly existence, and we are resurrected to a new life over which death has no effect. So the good news of the resurrection of Jesus Christ gives us this chance to make a choice. But we should know that since the dawn of time, God has chosen our life and not our death. He chose our recovery over our eternal downfall. Against our inability, if not our refusal, to choose what is always best for our salvation, God has chosen to give us eternal life through the passion, the death, and the resurrection of our Savior, in order to remind us that by remaining mortals, we are mortals not doomed to eternal death, but promised to life without end. So may the Lord make us true witnesses of this victory of life over death, for our life and our faith would be vain, would be empty, if we don't really believe in the resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.